For the first time, the world is coming together to celebrate World Burns Week. It's never been done before. This is the first time, and this week actually is World Burns Week. And Beyond Burns International, a Ghanaian non-profit organization that advocates for burn survivors, they've joined us in the studio this morning to let us know how they're also marking World Burns Week. In the studio with me this morning is Judith Kato Addison. She's a founder of Beyond Burns International, a burn survivor herself and an advocate. We also have David Amuzu, also a burn survivor and a member of Beyond Burns International. Welcome to the program.
Thank you. Thank you.
It's really good to have this conversation.
I'm excited.
Right. So let's talk about Beyond Burns before we segue into the World Burns Week. I know you're a burn survivor, but really, what inspired you to begin this journey, Beyond Burns International?
Let me say, somewhere in 2010, I started putting together a document, somewhere in 2008, actually. And by 2010, I had a document that said that at some point in my life, I would have an organization that would take care of burn survivors and so also talk about the prevention of burns, especially among children, since they make up the majority of burns we see in Ghana. And I tested the water at the time, and then it wasn't ripe for us to start because then I couldn't start up like funding it.
Yes.
You know, it was a challenge. I was a student and I was using my money, you know, to buy a few things for survivors in the hospital and stuff like that. To come to this point in my life where I feel like there's no better time to start. If you want to do it, you better start doing it. And in July, we just set a ruling.
Before I go to David, I want to ask you, how challenging is it to be a burn survivor and live and thrive like you're doing? I mean, I know you personally, so I know you're thriving, but how challenging is it?
I have seen different phases, you know, to this because it happened to me when I was 10 years old.
10?
Yeah.
You were 10?
Yeah. So at that point, you know, and there was no psychological support. And the whole process made me more, you know, internalizing a lot of the things that were happening to me at the time. I started just internalizing all of it and kind of advising myself from the beginning. So at some point, you know, your confidence is shaken and you don't know how you are managing or navigating this life. And it was difficult from the beginning to start. Yeah.
Well, I'm glad you're here doing this now.
Yeah.
So we get to speak to David Amuzu as well. David, how has it been? You're a burn survivor, you're out here advocating and marking International Burns Week. What's your life like?
Well, life becomes miserable. Let's take it that way. Sometimes you step out, people watch more than 10 times before you, you know, like someone passed by you, the person will be watching you as if you are not a human being.
Mm.
Yeah. So sometimes I have to leave home late, very early in the morning.
Does it hurt? Can you put your hand?
Yeah.
Does it hurt?
Seriously.
So you're in pain as we speak?
Very, I'm in pain.
What happened to you?
It was a car explosion.
Your car exploded? My goodness. Well, you survived.
Oh, definitely, yeah.
So does it make you uncomfortable when people are staring at you?
Exactly. Sometimes I see people staring at me, I'm so disturbed as a human being. Because as far as that's not how you are, and then people watch you more than 10 times before passing by you, you feel bad. You understand?
Judith talked about psychological support. Do you think you have adequate psychological support?
Definitely.
Where do you get the support from? Family, friends? Tell us about that.
Sometimes, you know, let's say a friend, sometimes a family friend. You know, you got to a point, you cannot even take a phone and call them again. Sometimes you call some people, definitely, it's difficult for them to pick a phone. Probably they may think you need something from them, right? So you got the point. I said, let me hold myself.
Well, thank you for sharing your story with us. So, Judith, how are we marking International Burns Week in Ghana? What are we doing? I know I've been seeing some interviews you've been doing on social media and the rest, but what's the program here so far?
Okay, so we started with webinars, which run through the whole week. So on the first, there was a speaker on the webinar talking about the current state of burns from a burn survivor's perspective in Ghana, talking about what's the burden of burns on the survivor, physical, nutritional, psychological, all of this. So we kind of elaborated on that. The whole point is trying to advocate for equity when it comes to burn care prevention and survivorship. Mm. So the whole week we have the webinars going on. But on the Ghana, from the Ghana front, we started school awareness yesterday. We went to the police depot 1 and 2, JHS and then primary. They have about 2,000 students. So try to go there a week before to sensitize them on burn prevention in their houses.
Yeah.
And then, yes. So we did that yesterday. Tomorrow we have the burn symposium.
Okay.
And
then where is it happening?
It's happening at 297 Tessano.
Okay.
Yeah. We are doing the Mr. Ampoma. He used to be doctor, but he's been, elevated. So he's Mr. Ampoma. He's the keynote speaker for tomorrow. And we have nurses and then physiotherapists, psychologists. We all come together at 297 to discuss what challenges survivors are going through. He's going to be there himself. And then after that, we'll have a fun time together. The whole point is to provide survivor support, really.
So yes. For this, the theme for International Burns Week is...
Burns, tackling the hidden global health crisis.
Tackling the hidden global crisis, because indeed, it's a global crisis, but we don't talk about it much. Before we wrap up, do you think that we are doing enough as a country in terms of our public institutions, government policies, and so on and so forth, to support burn survivors? Or to even talk about burns prevention, like you talk about?
The task is really daunting because to start with, we do not have government legislation mm-hmm. for the prevention of burns, like a potent one that's really working. And if anybody wants to advocate for prevention, what happens in terms of funding? You know, you'd have to do it yourself. And if you cannot raise the money, people get discouraged along the line.
Yeah.
So there has to be something that we're intentionally doing, you know, trying to stop this, because it's happening a lot to children. It happened to me as a child, and a lot of children are getting hot water burns, which are easily preventable,
right.
But because we are not focusing on the little things we can do in terms of education for mothers, even from the prenatal to postnatal, to let them know that now you have a child, one thing that's happening to children is that they're getting hot water burns. So as you go home, when you make your hot water, make sure you have cold water, mix it immediately, just in case your child, you know,
goes near it.
Exactly, especially when they start crawling.
You know?
Yeah.
Anyway, David, what will be your message to those watching us right now? Because we are, with this, creating awareness, we are also marking World Burns Week. What will be your message for those watching us?
My message to those people outside there is, anytime a fire, they never have a fire, they have to be careful of it. Probably cooking, they're cooking the food. Whatever those things, they have to be far away from the fire, And then probably that's what I can say for now.
Thank you so much for sharing your story and coming. Juju, anything we want to put out there, call for support, anything you need so that we wrap up?
Right. If you want to support Beyond Burns International, the number to call is 0594108880. 0594108880. And tomorrow, on Saturday, we have the Burns Awareness March. I'm inviting you to join us to talk about the prevention of burns on a wider scale. And then I think I'll speak for survivors when I say that burn survivors are just like you, and it can happen to you.
Yeah.
How you'd want to be treated in case you're a burn survivor, you should treat them as such. People do not like you to point fingers at them, make comments like they're not there, because we can hear you when you make these comments.
Judith Kato Addison, founder of Beyond Burns International, a burn survivor herself and an advocate. And we have David Amuzu, a burn survivor and a member of Beyond Burns International. Don't forget, on Saturday, they have Friday, you have the symposium.
Right.
Saturday, there's the Burns March at 2927, please. You can find Beyond Burns International across all social media platforms for more information and support the cause. Thank you so much for coming.
Thank you, Sweetie.
And I wish you the very best.
Thank you.
And 2927 is in Tessano, so please, just go onto your social media platforms and you find all the information there. Now, before we go, Ghana, get ready for the biggest giveaway from Syntex Tank. Syntex is giving 15 communities free water. And this is simply to say thank you, Ghana, for making us number one. Syntex was the first to introduce double-layer tanks in Ghana. Do you know that Syntex comes in so many different colors and sizes and was also the first to come out with inner white layer? So when it's not Syntex, forget about it. Now, if you're a community and you want to benefit from the Syntex free water giveaway, Just log on to their social media handles at Syntex Ghana and nominate your community. The more you nominate, the better chances you have of Syntex visiting your community. Remember, it's Syntex, S-I-N-T-E-X, Syntex Tank. No be any tank be tanko, the correct tank be Syntex Tank. Syntex, a strong, a tough. We take a break, we return with more on the AM show. Don't forget that there's that interview, AM exclusive with Benjamin Akakpo. Please stay with us.